Hello everyone. In this lecture, let's try to establish UART serial communication in Atmega 16 microcontroller. Let's get started. So we are just going to configure the UART communication that is available in the Atmega 16 microcontroller in this lecture. Let's get started. So this is the pinout of Atmega 16 microcontroller, and you can see the 14th and 15th pin, that is PD0 and PD1, are the channels for UART communication in this microcontroller. This PD0 14th pin is the receiver pin, and PD1 15th pin is the transmitter pin. So we are just going to use these two pins for transmitting and receiving data in UART bus. So I have derived some steps for configuring the UART communication in Atmega 16. So these are the steps that needs to be established. So the first step is, we just want to enable the global interrupt enable bit of our microcontroller. As we did in the previous lectures, this can be done by calling the function called SCI. So by calling this function, you can set the global interrupt enable bit. Why we are setting the global interrupt enable bit is that we are just going to receive the data from UART communication using UART receive interrupt. So that is why we are setting this bit. As I said, for using any interrupt in our microcontroller, we just want to set this global interrupt enable bit. So the second step is, we just want to enable the transmission and reception in UART communication. So coming to our data sheet, coming to the UART section, and under the USART register description, you can find this UCSRB register. That is nothing but USART Control and Status Register B. So this register is used for configuring the UART communication, and we also have a UCSRA register, which is nothing but USART Control and Status Register A. So these two are the registers that is used for configuring the USART communication in Atmega 16. So in this register, we just want to enable transmission and reception. You can see the third and fourth bit, TXEN and RXEN. So this third bit is nothing but the transmitter enable bit. So for enabling the transmission in USART communication, we just want to enable this bit. And for enabling the receiver section, we just want to enable this fourth bit, RXEN. So I'm enabling these two bits from the UCSRB register. And one more bit we just want to enable in this register, that is RXCIE, seventh bit. You can see this RXCIE is nothing but RX complete interrupt enable. So whenever we enable this bit, the UART module in our microcontroller will interrupt the processor whenever it receives a complete byte of data. So for receiving a complete byte of data in interrupt mode, we just want to enable this bit. So I'm enabling RXEN, TXEN and RXCIE bit from the UCSRB register. So I have enabled the transmission and reception in the control register of USART communication. So the next step is, we just want to set the data size for communication. So we are just going to receive only 1 byte of data, that is 8 bits of data. So that 8 bits must be set. Coming to our data sheet, you can see in this table, these 3 bits, UCS, Z0, Z1 and Z2 are used for setting the data size in our UART communication. So if these 3 bits are having the value 000, 5 bits mode is selected. So the data that we can transmit and receive in UART communication will be only of 5 bits. So in our case, we are just going to transmit 1 complete byte of data. So I am giving the value of 011 to these 3 bits, setting the data size to be 8 bits. that is nothing but one byte. So you can find UCS Z1 and Z0 in the first and second bit of UCSRC register, and this UCS Z2 is available in the UCSRB register. So I am giving the value of 011 to these three bits. So that's it. I have configured the data size to be 8 bits, that is 1 byte. So the next step is baud rate speed. We just want to set the speed of the baud rate to either high speed or low speed. That can be setted using the bit called U2X, that is available in the USART control and status register A. So this is the bit that is used for setting the baud rate speed. If this bit is 1, then the high speed baud rate transmission speed is selected, and if it is 0, then low speed transmission is selected. You can read this line, that is, writing this bit to 1 will reduce the divisor of the baud rate divider from 16 to 8. So if I set this bit by 1, then the divisor will become 8 and the high speed mode is selected. If I clear this bit, then the divisor will be 16, so the low speed mode is selected. So I am setting this bit in the UCSRA register. We are selecting high speed baud rate mode. Next thing is, we just want to set the baud rate. This is nothing but the speed of communication. Usually we will be using only 9600 as the baud rate for our UART communication. Since most of the devices like Bluetooth, RFID modules are most widely used in this baud rate. That is why we are setting that. So that can be setted in the register called USART baud rate registers. That is nothing but UBRRL and UBRRH. So this is a 16-bit value. So two registers, that is two 8-bit registers are given. That is, LSB 8 bits can be stored in the UBRRL and MSB 8 bits can be stored in UBRRH. So here under the baud rate register, you can find these tables, and in this you can find for F oscillator of 16 MHz for 9600 baud rate, when the U2X1 is selected, the UBRR register value is nothing but 207. So if you are using a different frequency crystal in your microcontroller, and if you are providing a 0 to U2X, you must find a appropriate value using this table provided in the data sheet of Atmega 16. So in my case, I am giving the value as 207. Since this 207 is less than 2 power 8, that is 256, you can directly provide this value to UBRRL register, and you can give a value of 0 to UBRRH register. So I am giving the value UBRRL equal to 207 and UBRRH equal to 0. So for your frequency and for your baud rate calculation, if the value is greater than 8-bit value, that is 256, which is nothing but 2 power 8, then you must give an appropriate value for UBRRH and UBRRL. And the next step is, we just want to implement the ISR function. The ISR function is nothing but ISR of USART underscore RXC vect. So this is the ISR function for receive interrupt in UART communication, and I am just declaring a variable called data. What I will do is, I am just going to store the data that I receive in the UART bus into the variable data. So in the data sheet, you can find UDR, which is nothing but the UART data register. So whatever data that is coming in the UART bus of our Atmega 16 microcontroller will be stored in the UDR register. So I am giving data equal to UDR. So the data that we receive in the UART bus will be stored to the variable called data. So thus we can receive a complete byte of data using interrupt in our UART communication. So for transferring one byte of data and a string of datas, I have written two more functions. That is this one, UART TX character. This function is used for transmitting one complete byte of data. Here you can see, I'm checking the UDRE bit in the UCSRA register. That is, I'm waiting for the transmit buffer to be empty. Coming to our data sheet, you can see, this is the UDRE in the UCSRA register. USART data register empty. If this bit is 1, then the transmit buffer in our UART communication is empty. So before loading any data for transmission, we must check whether the transmit buffer is empty. Otherwise, data collision may occur. So that is why we are checking for the transmit buffer to be empty. And if it is empty, the control will come out of this while loop and we are loading the data that we are passing to this function to the data register of UART communication, that is UDR. So that's it. This function is used for transmitting one complete byte of data, that is one byte of data. And this function, send string function, is used for transmitting a string of data. So let's understand this function using an example. Usually we will be calling this function like this, right? UART send string ABC. So whenever we pass a string in C language, this string will be followed by a null character, that is \0. If you are providing or not, this null character will be attached to the end of the string for indicating the string is complete. So we are just going to use this factor for passing string to the UART bus. That is, you can see, while of str of j not equal to null character, we are passing str of j. So str of j is nothing but str of 0. Initially the j is 0. So a will be transmitted. Str of 0 is a will be transmitted. And again, j is incremented, and now again it will be checked. Now also this condition will be true. And now str of 1 will be passed, that is b will be passed. Then j will be incremented to 2 and this c will be passed. And after that the j will become 3. And now you can see str of 3, as I said before, there will be a null character following the string. So now this condition will be failed because str of 3 is not equal to null character is false, because the null character is available in the string that is provided. So this condition will be false and the control will be exiting this loop. So thus a string of character can be passed to the UART bus using this function. So I hope you understood the configuration of UART communication in our Atmega 16 microcontroller. And we are just going to use this configuration lines for interfacing HC05 Bluetooth module and EM18 RFID module to our microcontroller Atmega 16 in the upcoming lectures. Thanks for watching.